Hey, Alan is here doing something solo. I just wanted to talk about something, and it would be a hassle to get everybody else involved. So what I wanted to talk about was framing, symbolism, and all that fun stuff. Because everything you watch uses it, basically, and well, you all will often recognize it as it is. It's more fun often to look at, analyze it. What does this symbolism mean? And almost all shows has this to some extent. So if I just take here Beastars, don't worry, everything I have is completely legal. This opening has, though, are both two characters running through the forest, and the forest is here Louis's antlers, and that would mean, of course, that these two are both trapped within his realm, so to say. But other anime does this too. For instance, a one that is, bear with me, in Shield Hero. Why, goddamn, everything starts with an S. Hero. Tatsunoyu Shonen. Yeah, there it is. So let's go to the still completely legal, of course, horrible subs, legal subgroup, etc. Just blah 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 blah. I don't care about you all. Give me a shot. Give me a shot. This stuff. Look at those three characters. And now for me. Those are standing in the light. Now for me standing in the dark. And these things, these characters in the back looking at you angrily. People standing in shadows. All that fun stuff. And of course, when it's in the light, people. Sorry about it. But shadows are important. Shadows is concealment, cloaking, shady business, and all that kind of stuff. Here, even these guys, the light is behind them, but they are not in the light. Just to mean, of course, they're evil. To some in some kind. And here again, Nofumi. Yeah, maybe the Nofumi with the one guy in the light doesn't mean anything. Sorry about that. But these guys are now in the dark. Basically, shadows are important. Because later, when the big betrayal happens. No, sorry, so earlier. Hey, look. Everybody is cloaked in shadows, half face cloaked in half shadow. That means they're evil. And of course, there was a big controversy about him buying slaves, and what I kind of missed in this whole discussion was how it's framed. Nafumi's face is cloaked in a half shadow. His face is somehow cloaked in half shadow. Despite being in the light, in the moonlight, the place is in a dark place, dimly lit. Somehow, at all times, both their faces are covered in shadows, at least partially. This is not a This is does not in any way indicate that these are good actions. Blah blah blah. So, when people say, oh, Shield Hero condones this or whatever, I really can't see it, because this whole place is framed as an evil business. And while we're at Shield Hero and Shady Shadows, if I go to another anime airing that season... Looking up things. Why can't I find things when I'm looking for them? And why does every show start with a damn S? These questions. Well, the show I'm talking about is Slime. Then, it's first... No? Then, say... Did I delete it? Well, never mind, then these are the actual episodes. Then I'll just... use paint. So... paint! We have our slime. And he comes in, he's of course first a man. Gets stabbed. And becomes slime guy. Well, it's of course... become slime guy. So, well, our shield hero man is evil because he buys a slave. Bad. He's very, very bad. This guy, our slime guy, good. And if you remember, the sun is shining. He's always happy and lit and all. There's no shadows. Trees. Look, there's a tree here. Somehow, the shadows this way. Just anything to get rid of the shadows in slime. But what slime does is, there comes a little creature, a goblin. Well, he's not very little. No, you're still bad. Yay, little goblin. The goblin goes, oh, slime, you're so great. Yay, slime. And then slime goes, good goblin, you are good. And what then slime does is, you are now named, leaf, because you are green. Yes, this is your name now. And then he goes, yay, name, leaf. And then he becomes big, strong. He has two lines, to indicate his strongness. And he has muscles and five fingers. And round eyes, with a smile. Yay! Yay, slime! I now swear loyalty to you. You are great and strong, and I will follow you forever. And then comes the next one. Next one. And he names him Plant, and he goes, yay, my name is Plant. And then the next one comes, and he is named, yay, my name is Green. And the next one, and they all swear eternal loyalty to him, with nothing in return. Yay. And then the question I have is comparing bad, oh, you're cut off now, whatever, bad, this guy is bad because he has a slave and that slave is treated, oh, she's reddish, she is thin at this stage anyway, thin and long hair and small. And round cute eyes. Very cute, of course, eh? Yes, very cute. And long hair. Yes, perfect. And now Fumi goes, first he goes, of course, kill. This is it. No. I'm scared. Scared. And then Nafumi goes, oh, you have the trauma thing. I'll help. And then, okay, I guess it's fine. And then she becomes big girl. Big girl, still long hair. Big girl with sword. Look, sword. And it is, she's always, yay. And he's like, he doesn't really, I said, here. Yeah, fine. She's like, sad. Small sad though. She wouldn't be like, oh, I'm disappointed in you, Nafumi-sama. But then let's go back to Slime here. Slime is like, or this guy is like, yay, I have name. Oh, it's ugly. I'll turn this into white again. Yay, I have name. I am so grateful, great Slime. And Slime is like, okay, make stuff. And then he goes, and then this guy, this character, whoop, gone. And Slime is like, no, you're gone. Oh, it's quicker this way. And Slime is, well, Slime, I'll go to some orphans and make them not kill themselves with magic for an episode or two. Because orcs are dead. Dead orcs. Orcs was here, he's dead now. Doesn't matter. And then these kids fuck off because they're not important either. And then he goes back. There's orc, I said. There's orc. Still, he's still strong, because he still has two lines everywhere, of course. And or he comes back, and orc is like four fingers, of course. No, five. One, two, three, four, whatever. And feet, and he's just like big eyes. Oh, is it round eyes? Round eyes. Yay, you are back. Yay, slime, you are back. I always believed in you, slime. Look, I built you something. I built you a thing. Look, it's for flowers. It's for flowers. And whatever, it's not important. And my point here is, in short, is this guy is way more of a slave than Rattalia is here. She has some sort of agency and does things on her own. These guys here live more for slime than the eternal obedient Rattalia is, because these guys don't live for anything. They're just there. And you have your recurring goblin characters, but what are their goals? They don't have any. They don't really have an history either. What were their lives before slime came? Living in the woods or something, but they didn't really not have any goals or anything to do before. I'll draw some woods. Did they really not have anything? Did they really not have anything to do before slime came? Or Rimuru, I should say. So, this is completely off the point where it started, symbolism and stuff. But I'll bring it back around by saying, these guys. Oh, you know, Fumi was always half cloaked in shadows, face in shadows. They're face cloaked in half shadows. And he's bad, and this whole situation is characterized a little bit as a dysfunctional relationship. Because, you know, she likes him, but he cares sort of for her. And that makes her sad. And that makes her a little. It makes him a little bit worried about sad. And he takes it as, oh, I might be gone someday, so I should take care that she would look on her own. But that makes her sad. And this is, of course, a whole complicated relationship in that sense. On the other hand, big man, yeah, slime, with no goals of his own. And let's make this the lessons of, just because the sun is shining, again this, but just because the sun is shining, yay, and a second sun for Rimuru himself, Just because. Shadows. Just because the sun is shining and somebody is happy doesn't mean the thing that is happening ma is a, it makes it okay. Yay. Rimuru's what Rimuru does is basically slavery. If I yeah, I didn't mention it before, but he basically enslaved these, and they are happy slaves, but that doesn't make it very right. Well, this thing here is complicated, and it's shown to be a little complicated. And that's okay. And this is just a comparison between these two. I don't really want to say that Slime is condoning slavery either. Slavery. No, slavery. Yay. And here. Yeah. Slave there. The orcs are slave of Rimuru. Just because they like it doesn't mean it's bad. Doesn't mean it isn't bad. And it's wrong to say that just because this relationship works doesn't mean it's good. Naofumi is rightfully derided for being a slave. But then the show makes a point of the other characters. Well, let's make a yellow guy. I'll do the rest in black so you see it better. The spear guy. Yes, those things have a red orb, right? Spear guy. It's all like bad. Bad. I'll make it proper B. Bad. This is bad. Slavery is bad. She is bad. And but then I'll pull up the episodes again. Tate no Nagari, blah blah blah. Yusha no Nagari. What episode was it again? Blah blah blah. That's earlier. Four? Yes. So what happens here is look. Now this spear guy's like, oh, slavery is bad. Oh, she's here against her will. Oh, I'm so scared to say anything. Oh, release me, great spear hero. And Shield Hero is like, fuck you. You don't believe me anyway, so I'm not going to do anything about it. So Shield, don't worry, fair maiden. I'll save you. Look, you are saved. I have chained you and gagged you. And now you are free. Yeah. That's what this is basically. Look how free she is. Look how free. Look how free she is. She's free. They say so. Shield, good job, Spear Hero. She's free. Thank you, Spear Hero. Now I am free. I am enchained and gagged. But thank you for freeing me. Basically. And this is one thing of. This is a very good example of showing a bad thing in a proper context, because it's complicated, this relationship. While here, Slime here doesn't care whatsoever about the monsters. He doesn't care. And all the monsters are, you have my internal gratitude and I'll do anything for you. Slavery, yay! And just to say again, just because the sun is shining, people are happy, yay! Doesn't mean that it's not something bad. And punishing Shield Hero for doing something bad and placing it in a proper context shouldn't be punished. Yeah, that's it.